When students come to this school, they learn a new way to walk. They learn a new way to talk. They learn that discipline in the classroom makes good grades. And they learn to become leaders. Join us for a look at the California Military Institute in Perris, home of the Rough Riders, on It's My School. Hi, I'm Tom Wellman with the Riverside County Office of Education. We're here today in Perris at the California Military Institute. CMI was established 9 years ago as a Perris Union High School District charter school. It launched with just 50 students in two temporary buildings in downtown Perris. Today, CMI has 900 students in grades 5 through 12 and a growing reputation for its disciplined approach to learning, tremendous test scores, and leadership training offered in all grades. With 30% of its student body now bussed in from surrounding communities, the word is out about CMI. It's becoming a destination charter school and a statewide model for student success. We're here at CMI today in Perris with Major Rick Wallace, the Commandant of the California Military Institute. Now, I've heard you talk about academics and academic achievement as being a real important part of what CMI does for its students. Tell me a little bit about how these Rough Riders do.
Okay. Everything we do is based off our academic program. The military discipline, the military structure supports academics. It provides the right mindset for cadets to come into class and learn. Our extracurricular activities, our athletics, we have a full range of high school athletic programs, football, basketball, volleyball. All of that supports our academic program. If a cadet doesn't do well academically, they can't stay here. And parents and cadets know that coming in.
My name is Angela Lawyer, assistant principal here at CMI. I began here as a teacher in 2008. I taught here teaching mathematics and science for 3 years. I've seen the academic rise of our student performance. We create a clear awareness with our cadets with regard to our expectations for high academic achievement.
My GPA is 4.0.
You're doing pretty good. How tough is it here academically?
CMI is a challenge. It's not an easy school to go to, but the teachers are so helpful. They pull you through it. They're an encouragement to the students, so I feel that it's a challenge, but not as much as you think it is. Even though we have smaller classes, we can talk to any teacher. It doesn't matter if you've ever had them before or not. You could just randomly go up to a teacher, and if they know the subject, they can come and teach you, and it's more like a family-based school.
You know, we've been steadily progressing. We've made, our teachers have made a concerted effort. We've done a lot of professional development, and it's paying off for us. Last year, our academic performance index was 825. Which puts us in, it was the best score in the district, and put us in the top tier of schools in Riverside County. This year our API is 856, which is a 32-point gain for us, and certainly puts us in the top rungs of all of Riverside County and perhaps in the state. We're very, very pleased with those results. We have a very unique environment. In that we have a military structure, but it's not a boot camp. This is not a school where the teachers or instructors are going to be in the cadet's face yelling and screaming and doing those sorts of things. But we are very strict about our discipline. We start with a uniform. Every cadet wears a uniform every day. And if they don't wear it properly, then they enter into our progressive discipline program. Wearing the uniform is the first step of self-discipline, and we're big on self-discipline.
CMI is part of the California Cadet Corps, the California National Guard's Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps program. In fact, this is the oldest JROTC program in the state. It dates to 1905, and it has its own curriculum for middle and high school students.
And we're working right now with the Cadet Corps to try to expand that curriculum. We want to make it a little more rigorous for our cadets. As I mentioned earlier, our 11th and 12th grade cadets are reading military scholars and doing those kinds of things.
Speaking of scholars at work, there goes a batch right now.
Yeah, they're coming back from morning formation. We just put the colors up, and so they're on their way back to class.
Good.
Yeah, because of our growth, we're the largest Cadet Corps unit in the state of California.
The largest. In the state.
Yeah. The next closest school to us is the school that we're actually modeled on, Oakland Military Institute up in Oakland, of course. And we're several hundred cadets larger than them now.
No kidding.
Yeah. So
you're the new model.
Yes. What we've done is we've tried to make as many leadership opportunities available as possible for our cadets. Our structure here, our military structure for the cadets, because of our growth last year, we were authorized to create a regiment. So we have a regimental staff of cadets. I have a cadet captain that's the regimental commander.
And she had another layer of leadership. Training, too.
Yes. We had so many cadets, and with just one battalion, we didn't have enough leadership billets for all of them. So when we created the regiment, we added another battalion. So we now have two battalions and a regiment.
Now, this is certainly a lot more leadership opportunities than a regular high school offers.
Oh, absolutely.
Leadership training on display.
On display. Yes, we're very proud of what our cadets do. All right.
Mr. Wallace, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
We're here now with Mr. David Sosa, who is a teacher here at California Military Institute, but before coming here, 2 years ago?
2 years ago.
He was 12 years in the United States Marine Corps and is a former Marine Corps drill instructor. Many of the students here probably, or at least may not, be interested in the military as a career or an option after high school. What are they getting out of coming to a high school that's like this?
I think because of the way the school is structured, there are plenty of servicemen and women that are actually employed here, and a lot of us are Marines. We employ the small unit leadership concept where we have each platoon is assigned a platoon leader and a platoon sergeant. And there's also a guide, there's squad leaders, and the positions will rotate periodically. The students are able to learn basic leadership skills that aren't necessarily just relevant to the military, but relevant to society at large. People are going to be asked to make decisions, timely decisions, honest decisions, and have integrity.
Are you having fun teaching this to the students?
This is one of the best experiences of my life outside of the Marine Corps, being a drill instructor, and to be able to have a second opportunity to do what I did in the military, to work with students from fifth grade all the way to 12th grade and have them develop into scared, frightened, unsure, insecure individuals, and within as short as maybe sometimes 10 weeks, we can have some of these fifth graders, sixth graders, and seventh graders who are assuming these leadership positions, and they look the part, they sound the part, and they're actually feeling the part because they assume these leadership positions and they take them very seriously.
Well, that's great. And I assume some of them might even become Marines.
Some of them hopefully will.
So what do you like best about CMI? You get to learn leadership and military bearing.
The thing about our school is it's small, so the classes are small. So the teachers, they try to really pay attention to every student and make sure that they understand the topics clearly.
I like being well-disciplined and being able to focus more on my education than anything else.